Well, good morning, Interbet fans, and welcome to the preview for the 9th of January. There's a Thursday meeting at the Vol. We've got a 21 pentrometer. The course is in fantastic condition. 2 meter spur to 600 meter mark. Lots to like about this card. And we kick off with a work riders race. That's the first run. This is about 1 o'clock. I'll tell you exactly what time, 5:01. And Flaming Duchess, Curvation, they look like the two that will fight this one out. Flaming Duchess, Mike the Cox runner. And Curvation with Sam Messier from the Mowing stable. Old Smear might be in Brig Improver. Has got Damasani on it, and he says he's the best jockey around, so that might be the Brig Improver. Race 2,000 metres, maiden plate, and Captain Hindsight, you really can't go against him. He looks like an absolute blinder. He got beaten last time because I thought Bantam was very late on the stick with him, because I don't think that he thought that he could get beaten by the good thing, which was and Green Gunston got up to beat him down the inside. Blow Me Down looks like a big danger. Dancing Flame got good form, third run after rest for Chase and Dory Sham. So they look like the right ones, and I think it's only a three-horse race, but Captain Hindsight should win. Race 3, Maiden Plate, Fillies and Mares, they go 1,000 metres. Rainbow Haze, lot to like about this one, got good form. It's the Blinkers, and Devon Abed, the stable's in very good form. Got to run very well. Single Red Rose, well, she's quick, this filly, there's not much of her, and she's got to be there or thereabouts. St. Joseph Lily, 1,000 metres, I'm not sure about. Carefully, this might be the springer in the race, number 9. Mark Kahn rides it, and got to run. Well, he's not riding Mark Kahn, actually. He's out today, so we'll see who the jockey changes. Izzy Cloth, Udalakis, and Van Rensburg are a good team, and they sprung a big surprise on Tuesday. Cost us quite a lot. Right, race 4. The Vol, 83 handicap, fillies and mares, 1,000 metres. Tough little races. Capitania from the Woodruff stable. Van Rensburg gets a ride. One has lost two. Comes back from a bit of a break. Mademoiselle's got very good form, very convincing, gives a chance. And Eskimo Kisses comes back from a rest, goes back to 1,000 metres. So what else is there? Florence, got to have some sort of chance as one. Glotoria might improve. Dennis Schwartz gets on this. Warren Kennedy, I think, got bruised up yesterday in the starting stalls, but he carried on riding, which is all credit to him. Race 5, mirror rated 76. And I like a bit of Claire Morris each way here. I think this is a very, very big runner, this filly. Raymond Danielson gets a ride on it. That's a worry, because if he's not in the right mood, then nothing gets in the right mood. What else? Mistress of My Fate comes back to 1,000, gets Gavlerina. Encryption 1-0 work riders. Moggy Brown's got some form. I really think Claire Morris gets a ride. She'll win race, and she's certainly worth having an each way on. Race 6, Merit Rater 104, 1,800 metres. Duke of Spin, second run after rest. Kennedy off, Murray on. You Can't Hurry Love. Looks like the absolute right horse. Kamalo, 52 on its back. And if this doesn't win, anything can win it. So I'm going with that as the right horse, but a very skinny 4-10. Can't be backing that. Race 7, Middle Stakes, 2,000 metres. And this is a tough one. St. John Gray holds the key. He's got At Hand with Calvin on it, drawn 16. And he's got Rocky Path. Warren was going to ride it. We'll see who the jockey change is. Drawn 2. Rocky Path's got good form, this horse, and he should run really well. Looking for a roughie in the race. Come the Day looks like the right horse to me as a roughie. Ryan Munger rides him, and he certainly gets on very well with this horse. He's won 3 out of the 11 starts he's ridden the horse, out of his 5 wins, and Come the Day, always useful, and he's worth putting into all your play. Major Return, they're taking the blinkers off. We fancied him with the blinkers on last time. He ran no type of race at all. Skimmernack, ignore his last run as well. Night Owl might improve. So quite a tough little race this. Race 8, Merit Rate is 74, 2,400 metres. Flame Fella got to have a chance. Robbie Sage, Gavlerina. When you see Gavlerina want to jump on one of Sage's, you've got to have a chance. Shane Calvin rides, won easily a work rider's race, but this is a whole different kettle of fish. Final Occasion, second run after rest. I don't like that at all with this horse's the profile, but he's got form and he's certainly got to have a chance. Out of your league, Kamalo, Fabian Habib, good last run. French Leave, this is a find of the race. Mark Kahn's not riding it, so we'll see who they put on it. Drawn 1, certainly goes his course. and loves a Vol, so don't leave him out of any of your play. All in all, very interesting days racing at Vol. Some of them look like you could get a good price, and certainly each way doubles looks like the way to go. From me, James Goodman, and the Interbet team, remember, sign on to Interbet, get the best odds, and you get the whole tote facility with no deductions.